Captain, there's artillery there, there, and there. All across the ridge. No good, Captain.
Damn.
Captain Cutter?
Yes, sir.
Colonel wants you to bring your troop and attack from the right flank.
Across that open ground, that's suicide. They got 100 martyrs zeroed in across the
island. I'm not here to discuss strategy. You have your orders.
Well, Colonel Turner lost his mind. That's an open field with martyrs. They're going to kill us out there. We can go around and...
Listen, I'm tired of your mouthing, Cutter. You have two choices. You can either follow orders or face a firing squad.
Yes, sir. What I like about the Army, they give you choices.
All right, Virgil, mount them up.
All right, boys. Mount them. Come on, move into position here. All right, boys, we got a bad one. Start! Fire!
Thank you.
I'm sick of this damn war. Going back up on the Buffalo. You ever been up on the Buffalo River?
No, Virch. Listen, Captain. You and Moon. I got something for you. Listen real close. Ever since I was a boy, I've been trapping beaver up there on the Buffalo River. Every now and then, I look down there amongst the rocks on the bottom, and I'd see a clear, shiny stone. Must have found a couple of hundred of them over the years. Always figured on taking them to some expert, find out what they was.
Captain, where are you? Where'd you go?
I'm here, Virgil. I'm here. Here, Virgil.
Oh, good. Good. Look, Captain. I hid them stones when I joined the army. Hid them real good. Up there on that mountain that the Indians are scared of. You know the place.
I've never been on a Buffalo Verge.
I want you and Moon to have them stones. My cabin hoop is still there. Now you go up the river till you come to that Needle Eye Rock. You look through that needle eye till you see them big bluffs up yonder. There's a cave up there. That's where I hid them stones. Watch yourself up there on that mountain. It's spooky up there. There was something up there. Followed me. Someone was after me.
Virgil. Who's going?
Looks like the Bluecoats have taken over your house, Captain.
Yeah, looks that way.
Oh, you can't go in there without an appointment?
Lee, honey, you're such an animal. You've got to give me time to...
Hi.
They told me you were dead.
Can't believe everything they say. Rosalie, what's wrong? Where's my mama?
She died last spring. We tried to get a hold of you. They told me you were dead.
Who's this Lee, honey?
Well, Major Blackburn and I.
Lee Blackburn? Oh, my God.
Oh, well, what did you expect? What, that I would sit around waiting and hoping that maybe someday you'd come home?
You know, when you're gone a long time, you tend to forget things you've always known. That you married a round hill. A Yankee living round hill.
You stinking... I wish you were dead.
You wish. Point. You got a cushy job doing the fighting. You got my house. My wife.
Rosalie, with all the Yankees around, couldn't you do better than a dunce of class of 51?
Listen, you turncoat scum. Get the hell out of my house. Sentry!
Your sentry's busy. Maybe you'd like to throw me out of my house.
You're damn right I would. I've been waiting for this ever since that lucky punch you...
You don't own this house anymore, and you don't own me. Just get out of here and leave us alone.
You'll pay for this, both of you.
War, didn't I? Almost every damn thing.
Go on, Clark. That's smart.
I know one thing, Captain.
Okay, hold on.
I'm gonna get out of here. Blackie's troops are gonna be on us.
Hell, them Yankees.
And I don't like your jails, Captain. I don't like your reservations.
All right.
I hate being poor. I'm getting old. I can't stand it.
We need money, Captain. What about Virgil Stone's?
Oh, you really think your rock's worth anything?
Captain, I don't know anything about stones except the arrowheads or flints.
You finished up there?
Just put this on.
Get the herbs.
There you go. Put your hand
on. Amos Richmond. Willie's brother? Well, he's always talking about how smart he is.
The geologist,
right. Damn right, rocks and such. I bet if we got a message to him. You ready?
Yeah.
He's in Little Rock, or he was. Get him to meet us at the loft. Down the hatch. Can I meet you?
I don't know what side of me this stuff drives crazy. On my Irish side or my Indian side. And it's yours.
All right, listen up, Teach. A third of the interest in what we might find up there. You'd be willing to go along with us up on the Buffalo River? Take a look at some rocks hidden out up there by friend ours?
Well, that's quite a tempting offer. I have my classes at the college. There are arrangements that I would have to make. I need time to think.
The way things stand now, you got about 5 minutes. We're in a little bit of trouble with the Yankees.
How long did you say it would take you to get ready?
I hurry. A couple of hours ought to do it.
Well, Captain, may I suggest that we hurry? Because I smell the bad breath of the bluecoats on our behinds.
Iris. Why, Iris?
Oh, watch out!
That's just a scratch. You'll be all right. Do you see what they look like?
I didn't see them. Can you get it out?
Oh, hell yeah, teach you. Look, there's a bullet. We'd have to dig it out.
There is no problem. Take a hit on that. This is real simple.
No problem?
Yeah.
Well, how are you going to remove it?
It's real simple. Breaking
off. Take another drink on that, boy. You'll be all right. It's a long way from your heart. You'll live.
I'm sure the captain means well. But what if the arrow was in my chest?
Don't ask. I don't know, Captain. I don't know the sign. These people, they must have come a long way.
Then why would they use arrows? All the Indian tribes I know of, they got better weapons than we got.
My head is filled with unanswered questions, Captain. I don't know. I don't know these people.
I got a feeling we're going to meet them pretty soon. Why don't you go up there somewhere, see if you see anybody coming.
The girl, what's wrong?
This job.
He raped her, didn't he?
I just can't figure out why they didn't scalp her. Come on, girl.
You taking out your sadistic tendencies on me. But this poor girl does not deserve your kind of brutality. It was disgusting, Captain.
Get a blanket, boy. Move. Here. Take a drink of this. Come on, it won't poison you. Drink it. Come on, damn it.
I've got a cup. I'll fetch it.
Girl. Come on. Open your mouth. Come on. Come on, swallow. Swallow.
That's good. See, I didn't kill you.
To your rapid recovery, miss. Got a name?
My name is Drusilla Wilcox.
Miss Wilcox.
I must apologize for Captain Cutter's behavior, which has come as a complete surprise to me. Are you feeling better now?
I thought I was dead. Who are you?
I'm Amos Richmond.
Who is he?
That's Captain Wishbone Cutter. Formerly of the 1st Arkansas Cavalry.
What brought you here? Where are you going?
We have some business upriver. And it's lucky for you we came along when we did.
Yes, I'm very grateful. I'm sorry you hurt yourself.
Oh, I'll be all right. Like the captain says, it's a long ways from my heart.
Is he always so cruel?
I really don't know the captain that well. You feeling better now? What an idiotic question to ask somebody who's just gone through what you had.
No. I'm fine. Really.
The other member of our party is Half Moon O'Brien. I'm told that his father was an Irish trapper and his mother a Cherokee squaw. He was an Army scout. And he's been with Captain Cutter many years.
I saw no one, Captain.
Take a minute.
No, it's not good.
What's wrong?
I couldn't find any signs, but I think somebody's following us. Somebody is following us, Captain.
Let's get the hell out of here.
These people who attacked and killed your family, how did they look?
They were strange. They were almost naked, and their bodies were painted all silvery. Had markings, blue and red markings on their faces.
How many?
It happened so sudden. I don't know. Maybe five, maybe six, maybe more.
Did you see their horses?
Oh, can't this wait till we stop? Can't you see Miss Wilcox is all tucker now?
It won't be long now.
Well, you'll rest you can tonight. We got a lot of hard riding ahead.
We rode all day like they were right behind us, and I never saw a thing.
You still believe we're being followed?
Now, Moon does. I'm gonna learn to expect company when his nose itches. She's asleep.
Yeah, she's all right now.
Good. I think it's time we ought to talk about what to do with her.
What do you mean?
Well, we either take her with us or we leave her behind. Or one of us can pack her out of here. Seems like it's all the choices we got.
Well, to even consider leaving her behind is ridiculous.
Well, we can't take her with us. That's insane. Look, if we find some stones up there, we're going to need time to set up some claims around this river. Can't keep her with us indefinitely. The less she knows about what we're doing up here, the better.
Well, I think Miss Wilcox can be trusted to be discreet.
Oh, damn it, Teach. This is not the Maypole dance. Well, likely your lady here will turn out to be some greedy little... Have this whole river bottle swarming with prospectors.
I do not understand your way of thinking.
One thing you got to understand, Teach, is rocks. And when the time comes, you just tell us which ones are worth something and which ones aren't.
Now, look. I'm not your dog on a leash, here to lead you to some ridiculous rock pile. I'm a full partner in this enterprise, and I will have my say.
Richmond, I want you to listen to me very carefully. You are a partner in the profits of this enterprise, if any, not in running it. And when the time comes, you will use your area of expertise to make decisions. But until then, Moon or I will decide what happens. And maybe if we're lucky, you will stay alive to share in the profits of what we find.
All right.
All right.
Then what's your decision? What's going to happen to Drusilla?
Moon, what do you think? The girl, should we take her with us or live behind?
If we leave the woman behind, they will find her and kill her. Or take her as a slave woman.
Now, before you make your decision, Captain, let me say this. If the lady stays behind, so do I.
All right. Since she's so anxious for some responsibility, she's all yours. I'm tired of looking at her. Come on.
son. Did you see it?
Drusilla, we could have shot you.
Did you know where you were?
Get down the tree.
What is it?
Shh.
Let's get back to the horses.
Moon, this arrow would have gone all the way through you.
Strange people, Captain. Why do they track us so cleverly and strike just once and then disappear?
Well, what I can't understand is why you can't track them.
I seen you track Osage Braves for 2 days across damn near solid rock.
These people leave no tracks, Captain. They move like a fog through the forest, leaving no trace.
Moon, if you're trying to scare me, you're doing it.
Got that needle handy?
You do seem somewhat the worse for wear.
Going downriver to sort my dress, if you'll allow me a little privacy.
Don't worry, we haven't been gone from civilization that long. Hey, don't pill around out there either. We ain't got all day. Drusilla? Ride with me.
I'd rather ride with Teach, thank you.
Teach is horse I'm concerned with, not you. An animal needs his burden lightened. Ride with me or you walk. Put your foot in that stirrup and give me your arm. All right. Go!
Captain.
my share of sentry duty. I'll relieve Half Moon so he can come in and dry out.
I'll stay down, Teach. You couldn't see a thing out there.
They're gonna come back here and slaughter those two up there. Well,
Captain, if I'm not back by noon, I won't be back. Miles down the river, Captain.
Yeah.
Somebody or something heard of them there. They were spooked as hell, Captain.
What the hell they?
What kind of weird claw marks are these? They like javelin or something?
Let's get the hell out of here. Let's forget about the stones.
Well, this thing's gotten to you, hadn't it, Moon?
I fear no man, Captain. You know that. Not natural people. The spirits. Demons.
Oh, Moon, I quit believing in spirits and demons when it's knee-high to a bobcat.
Captain, no man flies like a bird. Whatever chased our horses away is following us, leaves no tracks. I feel its presence. It's a spirit that moves through the air like the wind.
Let's quit it. Let's quit it. If we seriously start thinking things like that, we'll panic. Now, I don't know what the hell it is any more than you do. I'll tell you one thing. Whatever it is, it's real. It's got flesh and blood. It's not a ghost. I'm gonna kill it.
I go where you go, Captain. You know that. But you're wrong. I can track any man, but I cannot track a demon that leaves no tracks.
Figured they'd show up sooner or later.
Well, this one's different, Captain. It's not like the others.
Hell, you're right. That's not an Indian. Lord never made an Indian that clumsy, huh?
Maybe we should introduce ourselves, Captain.
All right, next time he moves, I'll pin him down. You fetch him.
Go on.
Thank you.
Don't move. No.
I meant how scared y'all, didn't I? Well, you like scared the pee out of me. I never been squirreled between a rock and a hard spot in all my life.
Except when that mama bear caught me in the cave with the three cubs.
You'd been better off with mama bear than with Moon. Why are you spying on us?
Spying?
Spying.
Well, me no dancer night. He's my partner. We're just out hunting fresh meat for the winter and... This is dangerous country, my friend. Fellas got to be careful.
You live around it?
Captain, there's a man behind you, a fat one.
Tell him to come on out here.
You got to be mistaken, my friend. Old dancer's way on up the river here.
Mister, if I've got to send Moon after him, old dancer ain't going to like it.
Dancer? Is that you? Why don't you come on out and meet our new friends? Now, y'all won't need those. Yeah, come on. This old dancer, he's my partner. You reckon we ought to have these folks up to Kevin for butt of that deer? Huh? What do you think about it? Huh? Show us! Show them that you want them.
That's it. Atta boy.
Y'all, come on.
Make yourself comfortable. You don't kind of tickle me to think y'all thought we were spying on you. Why?
You know, truth is, well, old dancer and I was in the army, but we didn't like it. So we left. So we come up here and hid out. And thing is, we didn't tell them we was going to leave. So, well, we figured we figured y'all were, well, you know, a guy can't be too careful.
Don't worry. Nobody's looking for you. We lost.
You did. I believe I'll put a little more wood on the fire. Yeah, now, first things first. Warm a gizzard.
Three men live here, Captain, not two.
Yeah, take all you need, friend.
The bushwhackers. They kill you for your boots.
Dancer, we're gonna need some wood in here now. Hurry it up. Hope y'all like deer stew. It's good. Dancer, you coming in here with that wood?
It's getting slower and slower.
What's wrong with him?
Well, old dancer, he ain't been right in the head for years. At least not since that eagle scratched him on the face.
Did you say an eagle made those scars?
Yeah.
Well, now, that's a little strange. Eagle never attacks anything it doesn't intend to eat.
Yeah, we figured it had to be an eagle. There's no other bird big enough to have claws like that.
Well, now, what did old dancer have to say about it?
Old dancer ain't talked in years. He talks as it happened.
Sure ain't no new Indians in here using black arrows?
Black arrows?
A little red, white marking skull. No?
Escaped me. Where you folks headed?
Up river, just hunting and fishing.
Won't be mighty lonely up there. No. Folks say that there's haints up there.
Haints?
Things that scare you. You know, like ghosts and things like that, you know, things you can't see.
Crap.
You couldn't get old dancer to go up there if you beat him with a stick. I figured he must have. That's where he got his
clawed on his eye from the eagle.
Any strangers and new people coming through here?
Well, we get a few trappers. We won't get a lot of them now that the weather's going to turn bad on us, but I never see them come back. Of course, they could find another place out, but...
You're going to Texas, Oklahoma. A lot of people leaving the South.
Y'all are more than welcome to stay. I mean, we got a warm cabin, we got plenty of deer meat, and plenty of places just to kind of bed down. More than welcome. More than welcome.
No, we got to move on. Thank you a lot.
Well, it sure was a pleasure having you folks stop by. It's going to get cold. Sure can't give you another jar of that honey to take along with you?
No, thanks. You've done enough. We're much obliged. Thank you. Let's move out.
Yep, y'all have a good trip. Just remember what old Posey told you. Don't you hate you? Don't scare you? Just my wife, Pat, take you right down the river. Sorry y'all lost the war.
All them powder on them because of you. Now get your gun and come on. Come on.
All right, hurry it up.
Come on!
They're setting up quite a surprise party for us up the way. You know.
On the horse's throat of shoe.
They're up in there for sure.
You sure that quacking idiot didn't tip our hand?
They're just having a little trouble with the mail.
You fix the horse's shoe. That'll give me time to check out their positions.
All right.
Mind if I make a suggestion?
Sure, why not?
You see those rocks up on the hillside there above the trail?
I saw them. What about them?
Well, while you and Half Moon change the shoe, Drusilla and I'll take a walk. I got a box of dynamite on the pack horse there. I'll take a couple of sticks up there with me, plant them in their proper positions, and the explosion will cause a landslide. That'll bury them.
It's a hell of a good idea.
Don't you be shooting that girl.
Listen, Rafe. I get the girl first.
I tell you do.
Now, don't be starting that with me. You had the last one first. It's my turn. That's only fair.
Yeah, well, I seen her, and I want her. You can have next two to come along.
I don't want the next two. I want her. And by God, I'm gonna have her. Well, hell, it could be a year before another one comes by.
You're gonna get her over my dead body.
Thank you.
close, Moon. There's that needle eye rock Virgil told us to look for.
Is out there.
Wait, listen.
What was that?
Did you hear? I don't give a damn. Just sit down and stay. Captain, I'll go see. I'll check it out.
Again, Moon. They're still following us. Wonder what that mattered to us.
They're demons. Oh, well, come on, let's get back. Come on, Moon.
Should have known. Sobe.
What?
Chaka Sobe. I know of this mountain, Captain. I've known of it all my life. No wonder Virgil hid the stones here. Every tribe knows this mountain. In the tongue of my mother, Chaka Sobe, the mountain of demons.
You mean you actually believe there's some connection between this place and the attacks on us?
There is a legend, Teach, of Chikara, a great and powerful eagle. Chikara took care of the people on this mountain, fed them, clothed and protected them from their enemies. The medicine man of the people became jealous of Chikara's great power and killed the magnificent bird. To hide his crime, he cast the bird into the river, but Chikara rose up and destroyed him. Chikara then cast the people off the mountain, forbidding them ever to return under penalty of death. Chakasobi. Anyone who enters this sacred ground will die.
Well, them Indian superstitions, right?
Hey, Moon. That Aaron teaches his arm. And holding there, is that real? What about the bears that killed Usula's people? They're real.
In superstition.
This is sacred ground. You don't understand. You go ahead. I'll catch up.
I didn't mean mean to make you mad, damn it. You're half Irish too, you know.
Y'all make yourselves at home.
Teach, would you ask Mr. Cutter if it's all right if somebody tells me what's going on?
Go ahead, tell her. If we find him, we can't hide it from her. If we don't, it don't matter no how.
I'm touched by your trust.
Anytime.
I just want you to know that it wasn't me. It was Cutter who was against taking you into our confidence.
I know. But tell me what the stones are.
Actually, we don't know.
You don't know? You came all this way and risked your lives for some kind of stones and you don't know what they are?
That's why I'm here. To identify and evaluate old Virgil's treasure. And there's no way we can possibly know until we find them.
But surely you must have some idea what they are.
Yeah, according to Virgil's description, Cutter thinks they're diamonds.
Diamonds?
All right, let's go explore.
He's half out of his mind, fear and pain. Maybe he's confused. Maybe we got the wrong cave.
Chakasobi is filled with many, many caves. We might never find the right one.
Those other instructions were accurate. That's got to be the right cave. Just got to look more careful.
We're not supposed to be here, Captain. The gods are against us.
Gods. To hell with the gods.
Maybe after we have a little something to eat, get a little rest,
We'll do much better in the morning.
Drusilla, what are we eating?
Eating? You didn't say anything to me about eating. You just said I was to keep watch and fire a shot if I saw somebody.
Girl, I didn't know how to tell you everything. Never mind.
Sorry, I'll make something now.
Oh, forget it, Moon. I can do it faster. Come on, Moon.
I said I was sorry, didn't I? What do you want me to do, get down on my knees and beg your forgiveness?
Girl, I can't think of a thing I want you to do when you get right down to it.
You've made one snide remark after another about me, and I'm sick of it. I didn't choose to be in your company any more than you chose to be in mine. But I've done my best to put up with you. Why don't you loan me a horse, and I'll ride out of here right now? If you won't do that, then the least you can do is just ignore my presence.
Consider yourself ignored.
That's telling him. I wondered how much abuse you were going to take
before you started fighting back.
That's all right. Everything's going to be all right.
Day. It's so beautiful. I got up and went for a walk.
Yes, it is, Drusilla, but there's much danger here.
It's so hard to believe, isn't it, when it's so beautiful? But you're right, I guess it was stupid.
Drusilla and I are going to go water the horses, Captain.
The hill must have collapsed. I don't see Drusilla anywhere, do you?
No. All the horses are gone.
Drusilla? Drusilla!
Help! Help!
We see you. We get you out of there. You all right?
I think so.
Go get them ropes off the cave, quick. On the double. Slack, you give me slack when I'll hold you hold.
Okay.
Ready?
Ready.
Here we come, girl!
A little slack. All right, give me a little more. Slack. All right. So far. Make sure you got a good foothold. Slack. It ain't broke, girl.
I don't know.
No slack, okay?
I got you. Come on up. Come on. You all right now? You all right? Look at me. Look at me. Come here. Come here. You all right now? You all right?
That's a good little girl.
I'll get you.
You sure nothing broke?
I don't know.
All right, Tate, you got her.
Oh,
it's no. All right.
Okay.
Well, you're going to have to stand right here. You're going to have to stand right there.
No.
Yes, you are. Come on. Come on, get your butt around there. Come on.
I got you.
All right, now listen to me. Tate! Hold on a second. Wait a second. All right, go down. You jump up on me piggyback here. Piggyback style. All right, get up on me. Go on up.
Hang on! Here we go!
I pulled! Gotcha, girl. I gotcha. Now, come on.
Nothing makes any difference anymore. But I bet I know where them rocks are.
Himself off that rock.
Yeah. Virgil had a lot of nerve. Well,
Well, I guess we're going to have to go down in there.
I hate to tell you this, Teach. But you're turning over the side.
Let me go.
Let me take it.
That's right.
Watch yourself now.
Give me more slack.
See anything yet?
No. Okay, a little more slack. Hold up. I think I found it.
Where's that?
Hey, sure is rotten bag, though. Bag's got a hole in it. I got another bag up there on the pack.
Drusilla, go get it. Get that man.
Tied to that rope. There's another rope there, too. Tie it on the rope and lower it down.
We'll take care of it. Come on, Drusilla, on double, girl.
There you go. Bring that bag on down.
Toss it on down. Give him plenty of rope.
Okay. You coming with it? Bring it on down. Okay, I got it. Now hold on a minute. Damn, dropped my torch. All right.
Over.
Now bring it up. Bring it up slowly.
Take it on.
You want it to bust open.
And Virgil.
Easy.
Slide one.
Easy. Now I'm going to turn loose on it. Gonna give it a nice yank. Here it goes. What about old Teach?
All right, you ready?
Magnificent.
Look at him. Well, Cutter, looks like you're going to be a rich man.
Fool if you don't.
In the meantime, we got 100 miles to go. On foot. I'm dead tired. You take the first watch.
He still gives the orders.
Thank you.
What are you doing out?
Shh. We'll wake the captain. I couldn't sleep, so I thought I'd try and keep you company.
That's real nice. Thank you.
Cold out here. Should have brought my blanket.
Well, it's so warm, still a little painful. If you move over on this side, I'll keep you warm. Is that better? To stay alert when you're doing that. I'm a watch, you know.
Want me to go away?
In any case, we gotta get the hell off this mountain. Tote down out of here. Oh, girl. What is it now? Come on, brace up, girl. Come on. We survived, didn't we? Come on. Girl, we got a long way to go. You can't fall apart on me now. Come on. Yes. It's not that bad. Come on. Yes.
the time. Where the hell are you?
Shakara.
Must have fallen all the way to the top.
Jeez, looks like it's all...